वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस साइड सोनिया हियर एंड जस्ट इन केस इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल, हिट द सब्सक्राइब बटन नाउ एंड डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू प्रेस द बेल आइकन सो दैट यू डू नॉट मिस एनी ऑफ आवर अपडेट्स. आई एम सुपर हैप्पी टू शेयर दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल. व्हाई? बिकॉज देयर आर थ्री रीजंस. वन, आई वाज आस्क्ड हाउ टू यूज डेकोपेज नैपकिंस रिंकल फ्री. सो दिस इज अ ट्यूटोरियल वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न एवरी inch and detail about decoupage napkins in detail. Secondly, I was asked how to use transforme sheets. Yes, you heard me right. How to use transforme sheets from Dress My Craft with the decoupage napkins. Can we blend it? Yes, of course we can do it, and you can see it here in this project where I have used my decoupage napkin and my transforme sheet, and this looks absolutely gorgeous. Thirdly, I was asked, can we do color blending and stamping together? How to do it? And this is just a perfect video where you can learn everything about decoupage, everything about transforme, and everything about stamping whenever you are doing a project. So yes, here I just want to explain you a little bit that what we have done. We have used metallic wax, we have used transforme sheets, we have used decoupage napkins, we have used stamps, we have used acrylic paints, we have used chalk paints. So yes, I could list out almost everything, and of course we have used varnish, but everything has been done in layers. It's not that we have done it just at one go. No, everything was done in the layer, and this is what you are going to learn today. And let's not waste any time and start this video. Now today we are going to alter a tray, and yes, in this I'm going to use my transforme sheets, my decoupage napkin, a lot of coloring techniques, and I'm sure you are going to love this. Now this tray is completely raw, so I had to prep up my base, and for prepping up my base I am using my gesso. This is a DIY gesso which I have made at home. Of course I'm listing down its link in the description box so that you can make your own supplies too. Now I am going to give one good coat of gesso on my complete tray, and I'm going to make sure that I spread this evenly, and for this I'm using my paint brush. Yes, you need to make sure that you cover each and area really really well so that you can start with your coloring techniques. Now here this process takes a little time, but this is something very important. Do not use acrylic paints for prepping up your base. Why? Because gesso are more important, and yes, they are something which helps in making your base, preparing up your base really well so that it can have any of the mediums on the top of it. Now I could have used my sponge dauber here, but I wanted to have a flat brush so that I can have a better coverage here. And yes, just in case if you realize that it has some marks, of course it has, but it's absolutely fine because like I said, I'm going to use too many mediums on the top of it, so the lines will not be visible at all. And of course we are going to play around with the colors here. Now here I am almost done, and I am going to let this dry for a good amount of time, and once this dries out then we are going to start with our chalk paint. Now here whenever you do your chalk paint, you have to make sure that you decide your colors really well, you decide on your shades really well. Now here I wanted to blend in two colors, that is red and orange, and you will see me blending this color really well on my inner part of my tray. Yes, here is the trick. I am not going to do this color on the outer part, only on the inner part of the tray. This is going to be the more highlighted part of my tray till I do my decoupage work. So as you see, somewhere I am having a red color patch, somewhere I am having a pink orange color patch, and it's absolutely fine. Here I have picked up two colors. You can choose 2, 3, 4, 5 shades, whichever you want, and trust me, you are going to love this color blending work. Now usually I prefer to have my sponge dauber for this, but I was absolutely fine with this very broad brush, and it works perfectly here. And I'm going to make sure that I apply this very nicely on my inner part of the tray. Of course on the outer sides I will have to make sure that I do not end up having any of the colors, because for decoupage I will be needing my plain white base. And why you need a white base or a decoupage technique. I have already done a video where I had shown you that what happens when you stick your napkins to any of the white bases and how it looks without any white bases. So that's a very important video. I will post the link of that also down in the description box. Also, I will try to mention that somewhere on the top of the screen so that you can check that. And yes, these are the very, very small things we do not even realize, but they make a huge, huge, huge impact, a huge difference in your projects. So I did not realize, and while talking to you, I'm almost done with my coloring book and this looks so gorgeous. Now here are the decoupage napkins which I'm going to use. Very quickly, I have already trimmed down the portions which I want to use and I'm removing the plies now. This is a very basic thing. Always make sure that you remove the plies of your napkins and then only stick it to your base so that you can get the actual look and feel of your decoupage napkins on your bases. I love using my Mod Podge and this is one of the best things which you can have in your craft room. So I use this for my decoupage projects, I use this for my mixed media projects and whatnot, and they look absolutely, absolutely nice, and they are such a best thing for your varieties of projects. Now here I'm almost done with one side of my napkin work and you can see me, I'm not pressurizing too much on my tray because on the other side I have my design. So very nicely I'm sticking one of the parts and then I'm just in gently pressing this with another flat brush and sticking all the nicks and corners of my napkin. That is very, very, very important. So like here, I am using just bits and pieces of napkin. If you want, you can stick the complete areas with the napkin. If you want, you can use your decoupage papers also. You can use your old magazine, printouts, cutouts, anything you want. But specifically for this video, I wanted to try out the transforme sheets and combine to my decoupage napkins, and that this was requested so many times on my page on my YouTube channel that can we do that, and of course you can do that, and that you will be seeing later on here. So yes, once we are done with our decoupage napkin work, then we are going to seal this up. And yes, before that we need to dry this up. Why? Because drying your decoupage napkin is really important. They are so thin, they are so delicate that we do not even realize and we just damage them. So just to avoid that, immediately use your heat gun and with your fingers you can just press out on any of the extra parts wherever you feel that there are some bubbles or wrinkles or gaps out there. Now with the sandpaper, I am going to just trim down all the nicks and corners, the extra papers wherever you can see on the tray. And if you don't have a sandpaper, you can use your paper nail filers. It works absolutely fine. So here my transforme sheets are ready and I have already pre-cut them so that I can stick them immediately. What you need to do is you just need to dip it in a water for 10 seconds and they are so good to go. You just need to peel off the plastic skin on the top of it, dip it in the water and stick it. Now this is super, super, super easy and you can see that how beautifully it has combined with my decoupage napkin. Yes, this is very important that you need to make sure that your base color, your base decoupage napkin, all the base work has dried out well. Unless until it has dried out, you should not use any other mediums on the top of it. Now very quickly I'm showing you that how you can use a transforme sheets with your decoupage napkins. Likewise, you can combine these with just the base paint with your decoupage papers, your decoupage rice papers, or you can even use these transforme sheets with any of your printable papers or the old magazines or the old covers, anything. Now here my tray is looking absolutely gorgeous. Yes, I have some of the beautiful designs here. Now I'll just cut this flower into half so that I can use it in two different parts of my tray. Again, like I said, it's very simple. Just dip it. First you need to remove the plastic film, dip it in the water for 10 seconds and then stick it on your base directly. Now I have planned to do this in a floral theme. Of course, I'm going to just break the monotony of floral because I do not like too much of floral things on any of the surfaces. So I will be using my stamping work to break the monotony of floral. But If you want, you can try out with the different designs available in the decoupage napkin and of course with the transforme sheets. So you can make these for any of the special occasions, like for an Indian theme, for Christmas, for New Year's, or for your regular use decoration. Now it's time to seal up my project, and here I'm using my varnish. This is very, very important. You need to seal your projects before doing your color blending work. And if you know me, you know that I love, love, love color blending technique. I am always looking forward to do my color blending techniques. And before that, we need to seal our project. So I'm using my varnish. And once this dries out, then we are going to use our colors to blend it. Now for drying out my tray, here I'm using my heat gun. This speeds up my process. Now it's time to break the monotony, and here I have my checkered stamp. Let me just do a bit and then I can show you. So this is how I am doing my stamping work in bits and pieces, and from the nick of the handle you can see the checkered stamp. So first I'm doing the sides, then I'm going to do it on the center of my tray. This is only for the inner part, not for the outer part, because we just want to have two contrast designs on this tray so that it has a complete look and feel of a different things at a time. So like you can see, this is a beautiful checkered stamp from Massive, and yes, I absolutely loved, loved, loved using this. Now once I'm done with my stamping, it's time to just cover it up with the colors. And for the colors here, I have first picked up my gray color. I know when I started deciding on the colors, I thought of using some blue color, some green color, or maybe the orange color, but then I settled down to the gray color. I'll tell you the reason why. Because my inner tray color is red, that's a red orangish prominent color. Now to settle that down and give this a little toned look, here I'm using a gray color, and using the gray color is actually going to highlight my floral pins a lot. So this is a quick tip: whenever you have such prominent and popping up colors of your transforme sheets or your decoupage napkins, you should use a lighter shade so that those colors come out really well. Now for example, if you have missed out on my video on table decor, do check that, because that's a medium where I have used all the transforme sheets, and I had used a very, very light pale color on the top of it, and that is actually helping in highlighting my designs a little more. Now wherever required, you can spray the water, and this is going to help in spreading the colors really well. Always keep a cloth handy, a clean cloth, cotton cloth, so that you can just wipe out any extra colors or any extra mediums from your base. I usually keep a spray bottle where I keep a plain water, and I always keep this handy whenever I'm doing my mixed media or my decoupage work. This really helps in blending up your color. This really helps in a quickly smudging of color, which looks so natural and so beautiful. So here I'm done with my gray color, and I will just dry this up so that we can move on to the beautiful yellow color. So yes, I thought of adding a tinge of yellow on the border. So here I have taken up a flat brush, and with the help of it, I am going to do it on my sides. Now when I started doing this yellow color, I just took up some other old brush, and then I said, oh, this is not working out, why I'm not feeling comfortable. And then I realized I was not using my Anukul paint brushes, which I absolutely love. And yes, with this very quickly I did my orange yellowish color on the borders. Now so I being in India, we love colors, we love adding drama to our project, and I just thought that adding a yellow color is going to add so much of drama and so much of contrast colors to my tray. Now this color is actually adding a new tone to it. So here on my tray, I have the reddish orangish color, then I have this yellow color, and then outer side I have such beautiful decoupage napkin and my transforme sheets, and then the gray color. So this is actually coming out really well. Even the stamping has also added some more extra charm to it, and yes, this actually is breaking the monotony of the floral prints. I love floral prints, but too much of floral print is something I thought I should break that in, particularly to this project. Now, whenever you are doing your coloring, you have to make sure that your tools are really good. I always insist on buying the very good quality supplies so that you don't have to do too much of mehnat or too much of excessive work to make your projects good. So this is done, and now it's time to do my favorite script stamping. So here I'm using a permanent ink pad and I'm going to stamp this on all the outer sides. Now, as you can see, on the inner side we had done the checkered stamp, and on the outer side we are doing the script stamp, and this looks absolutely fab. Now with the script stamp, they give a very nice and a subtle look, and they are one of the best fillers for any kind of projects we do. Now once I'm done with this, then I'm going to have my metallic wax and I'm going to do this on my project. Now honestly, when I bought this wax, I had no idea where and how I'm going to use it, but very recently I started using it and I'm absolutely in love with these. It's not that you cannot do this technique with any other paints or any other metallic colors, but these wax gives it such a rustic and a nice look. Now I'm thinking of buying some more shades of these metallics. So for these metallics, you can use your paint brushes, but I love using it with my fingers. So I just dip my fingers and I just rub it on the edges wherever I want. Later on, you will see me using the same wax with the paint brushes. So yeah, it's absolutely fine. It's not that you cannot use any of your tools with it, but you need to make sure that you clean them immediately and carefully. So here, as you can see, the outer side is looking fab. Now on the top of it, I'm just giving it a nice rustic look, and you can see that how beautiful this turns out to be. So actually now all the colors I have used in this tray are complementing each other so well. So I have my red orange color, then I have my yellow color, then I have my gray and floral prints and my green metallic wax, and this is looking fab. Now just because I had used my paint brushes for the inner coloring, now whenever I'm using my metallic wax, you can see the lines, and that is actually adding so much of drama to my tray, and that is really looking nice. So I'm thinking of making a video with this technique also. Just in case, if you want me to do a video on that, please do let me know in the comment section. Now here I'm just rubbing off my wax on each and every corner of the tray, and this is just to highlight the edges of the tray and add a little more drama, and this is looking absolutely gorgeous. Like I said, I will be using this wax with my brushes also and with my fingers, and this looks great now. Now I just forgot that on the handles I had to do the orange, the yellowish color, but it's never too late, you can always do it. So here I'm going to have my colors, and again I'll use a flat brush, and again I will be using my Anukul brush because I absolutely love the way it paints up your areas and the way it gives a nice finished look. Now this is very important. Whenever you are doing any of your projects, make sure you handle the color the handles really well, you cover up the sides really well. Now even on the back side of the tray, I am going to do a plain black color, and then I'm going to seal it up with my varnish. Yes, that is very important. Never ever leave your tray in such a shabby look. So but I always make sure that I do the back side of my tray or any of my projects at the end. So once I'm done with my complete project, I'll just let it dry for some good amount of time, and then I will do my black color on the back side. Now it's time to seal up my project, and for this I'm using my water-based varnish. I know you all have heard this from me so many times, and I absolutely love this varnish because this is so good for any kind of your mixed media and your decoupage projects. And yes, this looks fab now, and I'm so happy, and I'm trying and planning to make some more videos in similar lines. If you are interested, do let me know what should I make next, because I already have tons of things decided, but your suggestions are definitely going to help me out. Of course, I'm listed down all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. Thank you so much for watching. As yes, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye.
Triple